Switching gears now, psychological thriller Deleter emerged as the big winner at the 48th Metro Manila Film Festival. It bagged a total of 7 trophies, including Best Picture, Best Director, and the Best Actress prize for its lead star, Nadine Lustre. Let's now speak to its director, Mikael Red. Hi, Mick. Congratulations on your big win.
Thanks for having me.
Okay, glad to have you on the show, Mick. Well, did you expect this kind of reception from the audience? A lot of your tickets sold out in several cinemas across the country.
We're still processing it. No? Very surprised, especially for an R-rated horror movie to do so well this Christmas season. Just getting into MMFF is already a big shock for us. You know, we did not intend to have this film for MMFF, but it is the biggest platform right now to reach a wide audience locally, and we're just, you know, really honored to have won all the prizes at the major prizes at the MMFF Awards night, and now we're seeing steadily growing box office. We're just, you know, very honored and grateful, and we can't wait to, you know, continue sharing this film with Filipinos and maybe eventually even an international audience.
Mick, you're so used to winning awards already. You've already won. You already have several highly acclaimed films under your belt. What makes this MMFF sweep different from your previous big victories?
Well, this is definitely a bucket list for me. I've been in other film festivals, some grant giving local film festivals, but the MMFF is a platform that can really reach a big audience. And, you know, Christmas season, holiday season, everyone goes out to see the movies. It's almost tradition. So being here at the biggest local film festival and being recognized and having a lead star like Nadine, who is already an icon, and seeing this, you know, reception from the Filipino audience is definitely something that, you know, makes me proud as a filmmaker. Mm-hmm. When I make a film, my philosophy, my ideology is always to make sure that the message of the film, the story is conveyed to as much people as possible and to the people that matter. We don't want to just, you know, preach to the choir or to the echo chambers of the film industry. We really want to be seen by the people. So this is big for us.
And speaking of Nadine, how was it working with Nadine? You've already worked with other big stars, including Charo Santos, Bea Alonso, Maha Salvador. How was Nadine?
Yeah, I'm very lucky that, you know, the stories we come up with, the films, our ideas, a lot of actors really gravitate towards it because of the material, because it's something new, fresh, and interesting. And Nadine, when I met her, you know, she told me she's a really big fan of horror films. She likes movies. She has taste in movies. And it was so easy working with her because she's a very technical actress. She understands what I need as a filmmaker. And the process was smooth. And it's a very challenging role because when you think of good acting here in the Philippines, or when you say best actress, sometimes the expectation is really high drama where you really, you know, project your lines and it's highly emotional. But in this film, she plays a very apathetic, numb content moderator. So that's the challenge for her. She had to, you know, act with restraint and subtlety, and everything should just be seen in her body language and mannerisms and her eye movements. So it's a really tough role and mentally taxing, and I'm really happy that people saw merit and she won the award for best actress. Really proud.
And how did you help her actually get into that kind of role, considering that Nadine is known for her looks? How did you have some kind of workshops wherein you had to strip away her visuals so that she could just focus on the content and the material of her character?
Definitely, no. We had acting workshops, even with the acting coach. One of my constant collaborators and acting coaches during workshops is director Bombi Plata, who's also worked in my earlier movies like Birdshot. And for her role, I also showed her documentaries and interviews of real content moderators. In fact, she even interviewed, you know, one a real content moderator to really study, you know, their profession, this mysterious, very secretive, shadowy occupation, and get to know them and you know, learn all the nuances, the technical details, and you know, as an actress, I think she likes the challenge. You know, she wants to take on something new. Just like me, you know, we're the same as artists, where every film we make, we want to learn something and try a new approach and grow as a artist. So that was a very easy and exciting collaboration.
Okay, Mick, take us back to when you were filming this movie. Was it very difficult to actually create a movie with all the health restrictions in place compared to when you were still creating a movie pre-pandemic?
Definitely, you know. So many protocols are in place to make sure filming is now, you know, safer. We were actually one of the first to shoot in 2020 when I was doing another project, a series for HBO, and then I shot another film, Arisaka, late 2020. So we were already learning to cope and like to manage these new protocols and still make a very efficient, you know, production. So when we did Deleter, I already had some practice. So we tried to, you know, be safe, do our testing. Of course, there's it's tougher, especially for a genre film, because there's a limit to the headcount of people on set. And when you're doing genre, there's so many departments involved, more than a drama, because we have like stunts, prosthetics, effects. So you need more people, even though the headcount stays the same. And then now we have less shooting hours than before. So I feel like this is the type of film that I wouldn't be able to do if it was my first or second film. It's something that was easier because of the experience that we had, and the experience that we had even shooting in post pandemic situations through my 2020 shoot. So we were really lucky. The timing, the concept really worked because it's confined interior. So I think everything just aligned, and now the results are here, and we're very happy.
And what about funding? Because we all know that during the pandemic, the entertainment industry really took a hit. Everything had to be paused, and funding was just not there. Would it be safe to say that investors are now interested in putting their money again into this industry? Is it recuperating already?
It's exciting that this is actually my first collaboration with Viva Films, and they were one of the first to really adapt to the whole new normal when they started their streaming service. And as you can see, when we were all, you know, on lockdown, I think viewing habits really changed. Everyone was streaming on Netflix, and I think that helped the taste of the audience. I guess that's why Deleter is also working right now. As you can see, like, most of the viewers are from Gen Y, Gen Z. These are the viewers who probably watched a lot of streaming and Netflix, and now the metrics have changed. Mm-hmm. And that's why typically a horror movie, MMFF, would be like fourth or third place, and now we're second and climbing upward every day. So I think everyone is seeing this shift in preference of younger viewers. And at the same time, I think, you know, Viva has really learned how to innovate as well. I think they're even launching a new platform, another new streaming platform, Viva Prime. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I mean, right now with the numbers, we can't officially announce yet. I think next year MMFF will officially announce the gross, but the viewers are back. MMFF is now stronger because I think they tried like a hybrid version last year, where there's like an online screening and physical screenings. Now, I've been, you know, seeing pictures of people lining up sold out screenings everywhere. So it's really exciting that people are back, and maybe it's like revenge watching, you know, people miss their friends and they want to watch with their barcadas and just have a good time. And, you know, horror is also a good release because after like a good scare, people laugh. So I think it's definitely back, but streaming is also a big factor now. Yeah. So many streamers are coming in.
Okay, Mick, since you already mentioned streaming, how does it feel that in the age of movie streaming, your film is still making money? As I mentioned earlier, a lot of your tickets in several cinemas across the country still sold out.
It's great. I mean, that's the dream, to have like a good theatrical run and then maybe a festival run in the middle, and then towards the tail end you go to streaming. My earlier movie, for example, Arisaka, during that time there wasn't any theaters opened yet. So it was a direct Netflix sale. So that still works. That's a good model. But if you have theaters open again, you can actually, you know, recoup more. It can be more sustainable because you have this big theatrical run and then get a streaming deal at the tail end of distribution. So this is good, and if Deleter does well, it's also encouraging to a lot of other local studios that genre now has an audience and it is growing, and more films like this can be made. It's a R-rated horror movie, a psychological horror movie, so that's something really exciting for, especially for filmmakers like me that really want to do genre movies for the local Filipino audience.
All right, very, very quickly before we let you go, what is next for the Mikhail Red?
I can't officially announce the project yet, but a hint is I'm changing hats for now from director to showrunner. So I'm going to be a showrunner of a series, a sports genre series, and one that deals with financial crime. So something new and exciting for us.
Exciting times ahead. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Mikhail Red.
Thank you,
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.